Hello there, everyone, and welcome back to this Tsench campaign. So let's go straight ahead, I think, and attack this Dark Elf army and destroy it. The Dark Elf, of course, made quite a large invasion of our lands, and now we have to destroy them. Interestingly, though, I was a bit unsure of if the script would jump in and turn me into Chaos Undivided, as would happen if you were playing any other faction, that the Chaos Undivided faction would turn up.
Yes, yes.
And a viewer was kind enough to let me know that yes, that will in fact happen. But you have to destroy, you have to hold all the lands up in the north, and you have to destroy all the other Chaos factions, which I haven't done yet. So far we've only pushed Nurgal out of the game. Looks like a good setup. Oh, the Dark will start all the way over here. They're gonna hide in the forest to protect against my cannons and stuff. My cannon's not gonna be that useful inside the forest. Thing is, if we can somehow lure them out of the forest. Then we'll take all the cavalry. Yes, this is all of it. And move over here into the open area on the right to strike down our enemies. Dark Elf, they are a strong faction, although I am playing them on the Hot Seat campaign, and I'm not doing too well. The start is obviously very hard for them, and for the fact that they cannot recruit troops during a set number of turns each year when the harbors freeze, which makes it quite difficult to play as them, plus of course the money issue, and that I'm playing against other people but I'm not actually able to play the battles against them, and so I've been losing for quite a bit. I managed to take some settlements, but it's a very weak situation, and I do not have... It would be such a shame if I actually wouldn't be able to get anywhere in that campaign, but I'm hoping that greater problems will arise for the Kislevites, which are the ones attacking me right now, and that some sort of problem will befall them, which will give me a bit of room to actually recover some ground. We're in range now. Right, oh.
Hashat be praised! Hashat shall enslave their souls for eternity!
I was pretty worried there for a while, but then I saw there was actually Dark Riders, which is a pretty It's light cavalry, it's missile cavalry. So I was pretty sure that the dwarves would be able to handle it. So good in inflicting good damage there of the enemy. The main Dark Elf line though is holding. Let's start the advance. Slowly advancing up here on the enemy. And then we'll push the cavalry up, all the way up in the flank, and be ready to strike down into their flank. Now they have released the latest from Total War Warhammer is that they released that video showing off a bit of a campaign they were doing with the Empire, and there was not a lot of stuff like things you could complain about. I actually sort of got a bit hyped when I saw it. One of the things though is the towns. I guess they are still working on it, but I'd imagine that they would I was actually imagining those type of castle buildings that they had, that would be more specific castles in the same way that you have in say medieval. And I was actually expecting Altdorf to be sort of a big town, sort of like how they did in Rome 2 and Attila with the big cities of Rome and such. But I guess they're gonna change that as it goes along. Best to hold fire maybe with a cannon at this point.
We shall destroy them all. Tear them apart.
The enemy really can't stand against my attack at all. They've splintered up and they're running. Surrounding them on all sides. Was this something? I was thinking about something about with that video they showed. It was only about 7 minutes, so it wasn't like a huge amount of information, but what was it I was thinking about? No, I can't remember. It feels though there was something. Well, this went fairly easy. We've killed off 50% of the general though. Ah, there goes the enemy general. My general has suffered quite a bit of losses there to his unit, so we might just want to drag him out of there.
Strong.
It's hard to see what's going on in the forest. These guys... Let's see, there's that cavalry unit is not engaged in anything. So we can ride around and go for the Black Guard of Nagarond. And this unit's not engaged either, so we can move that up. Try to get around. Ah, there, the executioners are actually chasing my general. The general is actually very much in trouble. Yeah, no! The general was killed. Dark Elf executioner got him. But we will send the bastards off. No one expected this to be easy, given how many stacks the Dark Elves actually attacked with. I was thinking of maybe doing a... maybe I actually could possibly have time to do a very short campaign for the Dark Elves slash High Elves, where the main goal would just be to kill off... If I was playing as the Dark Elves, the main thing would be to kill off the High Elves and send them off. And the same with the other way. Ready your axes. Who is still standing? Is this guy out of the general's unit? Those two running, and then we got something over here. That's also running. Looks like everything's actually running. So... not entirely sure who's still standing. This guy's running. These guys are running. We've got something right here, also running. And the crosshairs are running. And... ah! The shades. These guys must have been running after them for quite a while. Send the cavalry after them. Chase them down. Dragging on the battle. Or if we could try to capture them. They're gonna hit the edge up there. Oh, there comes the cavalry. They'll capture them. There we go. Clear victory. We lost the general, but I have lots of generals. I have one general in each town. And I bet I will get... it maybe two to replace this guy. And we do not want you... Dark. Yes! Someone was there to replace him immediately. Oh! That was the heir? Hmm. I didn't even know that. Right. Let's go ahead and end turn. Got another general out running about. Apparently also I get a few, like maybe one stack or a general or something that spawns once I become the Chaos Undivided. Let's take a look. Production and population. City ready for upgrade. Chaos Dwarves mine. Mining network. Give a lot of good coin. Right, we'll actually retreat back here and regroup the army a bit. See if we can. I think we'll have to send some of these guys away. These four. We'll go and retrain over here, and then we'll get room for these four. Can protect against Redding Baron, Redding Blade. And we can end the reign of the Slaanesh in the north. And then it's about these battles over here. Gonna go ahead and attack this place. And then it's this we've laid siege to. Morgenstad. Continue along here. The provinces here are quite large, so we own quite a bit of land along here now. We only have to take out these dwarves. See about getting up quite the army to destroy them. Do I have anything else I need to move? I don't think so. We're recruiting people over here. Yes. Ah, yes, this place. We got a little rebel army turning up here. We have to deal with. Ooh, proven. Damn. Look at all this. Sloppy taxman. Trading ability. Marks of war can tell a tale. Admired technology. Good, good. Why are you so angry here? Very high tax rate. You get games then. Lots and lots of games. How about an altar which I can sacrifice the lot of you? That one and then the mining network. This is actually one of the places I make, probably the one that I make the most money. Up here in the corner, I make 5,000 from that place. Probably from a great mining network. Right, let's go ahead and end turn again. The Middenlanders haven't actually turned back yet. They're still actually part of Khorne. Sure, we'll take you on. Wherever you end up. Mission successful! Reinforce the region. Nice. I got some units here. Ah, he ended up here. Well, actually, where did the Dark Elf go? They went off, so we can take this entire army and continue on, and then you can go in and keep the settlement under control. Wanna build some temples to make them happy, so we can control them, and then I think we can create... Ah, yes! We do have enough money, don't we? So we could see about creating a new army from here. Now when I have all the nice smithing buildings and whatnot, and I can upgrade the armor of the troops, so we can have a proper good army that we can march through here and start going into Kislev land. Let the Dark Elf and the Dwarves fight it out while I lay siege to their castle. execute a lot of them. And yet another area fall to our control. Need to build some towers though along the coast here so we see what's going on. We have captured this area. Ah yes, there's another castle just over here, isn't there? Yep. Varl's Tower. This town is not a lot to not anything you could write home about. Right, was I done? No. I do not wish to lift the siege. Oh. Wait. Apparently 189 men almost has the same strength as my army. The thing though is those ogres really. And if you look at what I only have in my army, I think we're gonna have to play this one. Just to make sure to end Slaanesh in the north once and for all. And apparently also when I become Chaos Undivided, I will be able to recruit the other's special units, I think he said. So I will be able to recruit the demons of the other gods as well as my own, which will be pretty darn good, because I don't think my demons are that all that good actually. Gonna fight them there on the wall. Let's get moving. The main thing would be just to get in so I can open the door so the rest of the army can charge in, because on the wall trying to fight them there is not gonna really work, is it? Especially these guys. So what I need to do is I'll have to go inside, and then as I turn up here I'll have the axe throwers and the cavalry throw their axes and the spears in the backs of them. Ah, they're retreating. How nice of them. Gonna run all the way back to capital or into the center of town and hold that area. Since we've got the gate, we'll move in these guys. They'll come in the flank. So once we'll engage the main force here in the center of town, we can have the cavalry move in on the. Where are they going? Nope, not that way, you idiots. Go over here. What would you
have us do? Ready your axes! March quickly.
Wait, what? They still moved through here? Didn't I? I sent them down here, but they still. Sometimes. Going. Bloody hell. Great stuff! Wow, the entire unit was massacred. And the X-throwers as well. Or at least part of them. Well, it could have been worse. In some way. Right, let's get this plan on the way.
The skill and courage of my warriors.
We want to engage all of them so we can go up and throw axes in the back. We just run straight through this unit.
March onwards, brothers.
We are destined to win.
There's only one guy left, and victory.
We's the best and we's the meanest.
The bird god is strong.
March onwards,
bird
brothers.
God.
Pray for
the
mutation.
Fear us, fear us. We cannot be stopped. Why talk when we could fight?
The Raven God is
watching.
That cavalry charge killed off a lot of people. Right, let's throw in the cavalry and the axe throwers. Damn, that cavalry unit's just mopping them all up. Let's get over here. So far, the enemy has lost 71% of their force, 72% of their force. And I've lost 31. But then we have to remember that I outnumber them, like, I don't know how many. I had 1500 or something, and they maybe had 150. Kill the general. Not that that actually will help that much, so let's throw on the big beast, shall we?
Ready your axes! Ready your axes! Lead us!
Taste the blade!
It's gonna take quite a while to cut down all of these 28 bastards. The main thing is that we have to surround them, so maybe standing here and throwing stuff in their back is not gonna do that much. Here comes the axe throwers. I do think these guys will be able to deliver quite a bit of damage. Wow, they ran right into them. Yes. The axes are able to kill quite a few of them. A tactic that I've found very useful in Attila, because I'm playing it a bit now, is the Byzantium Empire, or the East Roman Empire, to move troops in behind and throw spears and whatever you want to throw at your enemy. The axes are actually killing quite a lot of them. This is going a lot smoother than I thought it would. I thought it would take quite a while, but even if you are a big beast like this, if you get a, say, 124 axes being thrown straight in your face, I think you would die just the same. When I say face, I mean the face here in the middle, not the two ones he has on his arm. I think that went pretty smooth. We killed off the... We only lost half our force. But it's a worthy sacrifice for the bird god. They didn't really have anything in this province either. Good, good. Now it's only this place left. And we've already recruited quite a few warriors here. Which we can march out, and then we can combine all these forces. Go down, throw the Dark Elves out, and we can move them across with the navy. That place is going to fall pretty darn quick. Historical note! Marienburg. Oh. They still have quite a bit of power left, the Dark Elves, but I'm pretty sure if we go in, on the tab here... Oh, we can see we're shooting up pretty darn straight. Military ranking going up. Production ranking. Territorial ranking, financial, population is soaring. Let's add in the Dark Elves. Overall ranking, they're beginning to see a slope here because of the war. Military ranking is actually higher than us. Production is nowhere near. And territorial, just the same. Financially, they're bankrupt. Right, anyways. Looking at the time, we're gonna have to end it here, so hopefully you enjoy this episode, and hopefully I'll see you guys for the next one. Bye!